And with even more brutality upon brutality that has been taking place, and just what's been a fantastic day of boxing, Raymundo Beltran completely obliterates Jonathan Maicelo with what might wind up actually becoming the knockout of the year. I mean, that was really just an incredible, incredible knockout that he scored in the second round, taking care of business. The first round started a little bit rocky for Raymundo Beltran. A knockdown wound up getting called off of a clash of heads. Their heads clashed. The ref called it a knockdown, even though there was no punch actually landed. It was just a clash of heads, and Beltran went down. You know, he was forced off his feet just from the clash of heads. And funny enough, I mean, the referee actually stopped the action about 10, 15 seconds later to have the doctor take a look at Jonathan Maicelo's head, because of the fact that he was bleeding up above his eye. From, you know, a cut that he sustained in the midst of the head clash. I mean, Beltran was cut as well, up a little bit higher on the head. But, I mean, he fought on in the first round. Maicelo was landing actually some pretty good combination punches, fighting well. Very fast hands from Maicelo, very quick feet as well. He's almost like an orthodox version of like a Sergio Martinez type fighter. But he has shown himself to be chinny in the past, which is the key to, was the key basically to this fight and to Beltran winning it. Beltran did manage to rock Maicelo at the end of the first round, caught him with a couple of, like, a left hook, right hand, left hook combo, and a couple of the last shots were thrown, you know, right as the bell was sounding, and also after the bell, so the ref wound up actually not calling it a knockdown, just said that they were, you know, kind of accidental late shots, put him off to the corners and everything, so, you know, Maicelo technically probably had a 10-8 advantage on the scorecards. Second round, however, Maicelo was still kind of trying to ratchet off those quick combination punches, left, right, and Beltran just caught him with a clean left hook, and it was crazy because they actually threw left hooks at the same time. It's like Maicelo threw his, Beltran timed it perfectly to throw his left hook, caught Maicelo right on the button, right at the tip of the chin. Maicelo went down, his head smacked against the canvas, not once, but twice. Like, that was like some Street Fighter 2 shit, like when, you know, when you knock a guy out, and it's like they bounce up off the floor. Like, that's how brutal it was. That's how violent it was. And Maicelo, I'm not even playing, was out. He was knocked out cold for about 3 minutes, 4 minutes before he, like, he even showed any kind of movement, like, in his limbs, you know? Like, his legs were shaking while he was not out cold. And, I mean, it was nasty, man. So, you know, they definitely had to take the precautions in, you know, they're in New York and everything. Have to take the precautions after what happened to Magomed Abdusalamov, unfortunately. And, you know, they carried him out on the stretcher. But, I mean, he was just absolutely brutalized, man. Maicelo, it took him minutes upon minutes to finally wake up from that knockout. Just an absolutely vicious KO from Beltran. I mean, I've given Beltran shit in the past because of the fact that he tested positive for a past fight. I'm trying to remember the name of the fighter that he tested positive against. It was a fighter from Japan. I'm blanking on his name at the moment. Ayo, Takeo Ayo, but Beltran, I mean, as long as he's passing the test, I mean, which he has since then, and, you know, he did against Terrence Crawford, you know, he's been just crushing guys, man, just absolutely obliterating people. My bad, though, the Ayo fight happened after Crawford was, but, I mean, I guess, you know, they're talking, making a much ado about him potentially winning his right to stay in the country, in the United States, get his green card, which is all nice, good for him. Glad, happy to see that he's able to kind of move forward with his life and stuff after having a, you know, tough past, tough childhood and all that stuff. You know, it's the name of the game in the sport of boxing, by and large, more often than not. But absolutely savage KO from Beltran. That is pretty much probably going to be that or Stevens versus Lemieux and Stevens. For knockout of the year. I think this one might take the cake, though. I mean, that just the cleanness of that hook, man, and just the way that he fell, it bounced, like, graphic. I mean, that should be rated R, man. Gotta have parental supervision to watch a knockout like that. But that's all I got to say about this one, and I will catch you guys on the next. Peace.